about the setup. We're in a spot that Jason's got permission on. It's probably a 98% success rate right here. Every time we come, we see a dog or kill a dog, or it's definitely a great spot. Let me show you the setup here. It's a really cool field. It's just a lot of rolling hills. We're up on the high point of the field, and we had the decoy out right here. You ready? There you go. There you go. Coming up. It's going to be at the top of the ridge. Top of the ridge. That's a wrap. All right, there's the other one over on the hill over here. Straight across. Just wait, maybe it'll see what it'll do. See what it'll do. Nope. That was a cluster. You might can hit that one. See, stops right there. Yeah. Good shot. All right, guys, we got one on the ground here. We probably should have had a double, but Jason's gun, for some reason, it didn't shoot the first round. But started out with fawn today. I don't know why, but sure enough, and we've got the coyote decoy out too. But we started with some fawn, and Jason said they were going to come right here beside us, and sure enough. Well, Jason sees one come over the hill in front of us, and I see one bouncing over the ridge right here. It gets within, 100 yards, and Jason has it, basically broadside, and his gun misfired. He tried to get another round in, and it took off. We couldn't get it stopped. We changed to Pound Town. The other one comes down and makes probably a 200-yard shot on it. And you can still hear, we've got the other one just still, it's been booger barking us for 15 minutes. We can't get it to come out. But anyways, I think we had them out within a minute, Jason?
Happened pretty quick today.
Probably a minute they were down, on, or at least in front of us. It's been a while since we've hunted. He's at the lake every weekend, so it's fun to get out here and get one on the ground. So we're fixing to go try to get another one before it gets too hot. Thanks for watching, guys.